Hello everyone, welcome to the course of Maths for NTSC Concept. In last video, we have seen some problems which are useful for NTSC. Continuation of the last class. Here we are discussing some more problems. Let's start. The first question. If the straight lines 12y is equal to minus of p plus 3 into x plus 12, comma 12x minus 7y is equal to 16 or perpendicular, then find p value. Here they gave two lines and those two lines are perpendicular. Then they are asking p. Okay, we know that if two lines are perpendicular, then product of the slopes is equal to minus 1. That concept we are using here. The first equation I am taking here. The first equation. Okay, these RHS terms all, bring to LHS set. So what will happen? So 12y, this minus of p plus 3 into x transpose means plus p plus 3 into x plus 12 coming means minus 12 is equal to 0. Okay, this is equation 1. Second equation also, RHS set 16 is the transpose. So 12x minus 7y minus 16 is equal to 0. This is equation 2. Okay. Now we want to find slopes. How to find slopes? Okay, we have a formula. That formula I will write here. Slope of a line which is of the form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is minus a by b. This is the form we are using here. This formula is useful. So m1 is the first line slope, m2 is the second line slope, m1 m2. So I am finding here m1 is equal to minus x quotient. This is the x quotient. So minus of p plus 3 by y quotient is 12. M2 I am finding here, M2, x quotient is 12, so minus 12 by minus 7, both minus will cancel, so 12 by 7, okay, so product of the two slopes will be equal to minus 1, so M1 into M2 is equal to minus 1, M1 is minus of p plus 3 by 12 into 12 by 7 is equal to minus 1. Okay, now let's simplify here. Minus minus will cancel, 12 total also will cancel. This 7 if you send means p plus 3 is equal to 7, p is equal to 4. That's it. This is the problem. They are asking p value. We got p is equal to 4. Hope you understand. Let's see next problem. Find the equation of a line passing through 6, minus 2 and perpendicular to the line joining 6, 7, 2, minus 3. Okay. The our line. Our line is passing through this point and perpendicular to joining these two lines. Okay. Means here two lines having, one line is our line, another line is passing through this point and our line is perpendicular to this point. So let's find the slope of this perpendicular line. Okay, this slope you can take as m dash. M dash I am finding, m dash is equal to, whenever two points given, formula is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, same thing you apply. Like this arrow mark you put now, it will not happen mistakes. So minus 3 minus 7 by 2 minus 6. So minus 10 by minus 4 will give you 2 5 0 2 2 0. So 5 by 2 m dash we got. But our line is perpendicular to this line, the line which having slope m dash. So required slope we can get here. Required slope we can take as m. M is equal to, how it will come? Minus 1 by m dash. Required slope, whenever two lines are perpendicular, required slope is equal to minus 1 by the given slope. So minus 1 by 5 by 2 will give you minus 2 by 5. So M we have, point they give P. Px1 comma y1 is equal to 6 comma minus 2. We have slope, we have point. Then we can use point slope form. They are asking equation, so we want to use point slope form. What is the point slope form? Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. This form we are going to use here. So m we have here, m we have, x1, y1 we have, just substitute, answer will come. Y minus y1 means plus 2 is equal to m is minus 2 by 5 into x minus 6. This denominator, just you transpose, it will multiply here. So 5y plus 2 5z 10 is equal to minus 2x minus minus plus 12. This RH system bring to left hand side. So what will happen? 5y plus 10 plus 2x minus 12 is equal to 0. Let's simplify. 2x plus 5y, 10 minus 12 means minus 2 is equal to 0. This is our answer. 2x plus 5y minus 12 is equal to 0. First we found the slope passing through the given points. After that, required slope means minus 1 by the whatever you got slope. So point they give, we applied point slope form, we got answer. Let's see another problem. Find the equation of the perpendicular bisector of the line joining the points A minus 4 comma 2, B 6 comma minus 4. This is the problem. Okay, here we have a line which joining A minus 4 comma 2, B 6 comma minus 4. We want to find perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular means which is the line which is the required line is perpendicular, and bisector means it bisect the given line segment. So this length and this length means this length and this length, both are same. Okay, so this foot is called midpoint. You can take as P. P is the midpoint of AB, and this line is required line, required line. Okay, so P we can find here. P is the midpoint of AB. So we can find midpoint formula x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2 minus 4 plus 6 means 2 by 2 comma 2 minus 4 means minus 2 by 2. So you will get here 1 comma minus 1. We got P as 1 comma minus 1. Well, we have P. If you find slope means automatically we can find whatever the line they are asking. So this line and this line are perpendicular. Let's find slope of AB. Slope of AB I am taking as M dash. That is nothing but slope of AB. Formula y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. Apply here. So minus 4 minus 2 by 6 plus 4. You will get here minus 6 by 10. So if you simplify means minus 3 by 5 will come. So required slope we have to get here. Required slope means M we can take. This is required. Required just minus 1 by this one, minus 1 by this slope, minus 3 by 5, minus minus will cancel, so you will get 5 by 3. This is M. We got here point, this is x1 y1. So same thing, apply the slope point form. Slope point form nothing but y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. So we got y minus y1, this is x1, y1. Y1 is minus 1, so plus 1 is equal to 5 by 3 into x minus 1. So 3 if you transpose means 3y plus 3 is equal to 5x minus 5. So these terms take and go and simplify, you will get 5x minus 3y minus 8 is equal to 0. This is the required equation. Here what we did, perpendicular bisector means midpoint of the given line segment we found, that is our required point through which line passing, and slope of AB after that required slope we found. Let's recall the solution so that you can understand. Okay, let's move the last problem. Find the equation of a straight line through the intersection of the lines 7x plus 3y is equal to 10, 5x minus 4y is equal to what, and parallel to this one. Parallel to means we can find slope, so that slopes are equal, we are getting here slope. So first to find slope, or else first you can solve these two lines, you will get a point, that point is your required point. Point we have, slope we have, we can solve. So I am solving the first two lines. So this line I am taking equation 1 and this line I am taking equation 2. Solving 1 and 2. Okay. How to solve? We have cross multiplying method. That method I am going to use here. So first y. Y means minus 3. Next constant means minus 10. Next x means 7. This format just look at, we have studied, and after that minus 3. But then our next line, second line, you see minus 4, minus 1, 5, minus 4. Okay, how this will come? X by is equal to y by is equal to 1 by. Just do cross multiply, so you will get the answer. Cross multiply you do. So minus 3 into minus 1 is 3 minus 40. Yes or no? This is the two lines they gave to us. So coefficients, how to write? First y coefficient here, plus will come, sorry, plus 3. I took wrongly here, 1 minute. Here plus 3, here last also plus 3. Okay, so what will happen? Minus 3 will come here, minus 3 will come, minus 3 minus 40. Let's here also cross multiply, minus 50 plus 7 will come. Next minus 28 minus 15. So let's simplify, x by minus 43 is equal to y by minus 43 is equal to 1 by minus 43. So after that you know how to simplify, equating first and last. So x by minus 43 is equal to 1 by minus 43, both will cancel, x is equal to 1. Same way, similarly y also will come, y because 43 will cancel, so 1 will come, p is equal to 1 comma 1. So this is your x1 comma y1. Okay, they gave another line, what is the line? 13x plus 5y plus 12 is equal to 0. Okay, slope m dash find out. Okay, slope m dash means slope of this line, minus 13 by 5, we know formula, minus x coefficient by y coefficient. So required slope, that is nothing but m. When two lines are parallel, slopes are equal, so same slope will come, minus 13 by 5. We have slope, we have point, so we can use slope point form to get the equation. I am doing that one. So the formula is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. So y minus 1 is equal to m means minus 13 by 5 into x minus 1. Just 5 transpose means 5y minus 5 is equal to minus 13 multiply means minus 13x plus 13. Okay, these all the terms taken come this side, so that you will get correct answer. So 13x प्लस 5y माइनस 18, 13 कमिंग मीन्स माइनस 13 ऑलरेडी 5 इज देयर, सो माइनस 18 इज इक्वल टू 0. दिस इज द सॉल्यूशन. होप यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट वी डिड हियर. फर्स्ट आई सॉल्व द टू लाइंस. After solving the two lines, I got 1,1. 1,1 is the point through which our line is passing, and one more line given, that line slope I found, and they said these two lines are parallel, so slopes are equal. Same slope I am taking as the required line slope. So after that, the equation y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1, that formula I applied, I got the equation, that's it. Hope you understand. Today 4 problems we have discussed. All 4 are very very important. Okay, let's practice one more time so that you can understand. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.